Hello, and welcome to How Do You Get 30,000 Photo Attachments Out of ArcGIS Enterprise, or ArcGIS Online. My name is Carl von Stetten. I'm a GIS analyst with Central San, where I've worked since 2000, and have been using FME since about 2002. Central San is a wastewater collection and treatment agency serving nearly 500,000 people in central Contra Costa County, which is located in the San Francisco Bay Area in Northern California. Our headquarters are located in Martinez. This is an agenda of the discussion this morning. I'll talk about why we had to extract ArcGIS attachments, some of the technical issues that were involved, and some tips for developing ArcGIS attachment workspaces. So we were assigned a project to inspect all of our sanitary sewer access structures, and we have a variety of types, as you can see from the table there. And in total, we've got almost 39,000 structures. And we needed to improve the location precision for these structures in our GIS system. Now, many of these structures are concealed under tree canopies, so we are not able to use aerial imagery to fine-tune their location. So the project involved having someone go out and visit each structure, take a close-up photo of the structure cover, and then two or three additional photos to help identify the location and the context. We also needed to capture whether the structure was located in bike lanes, pedestrian walking paths, or in public or private streets. We also needed to identify any potential safety hazards and flag those for review and corrective action. So our group built a field data collection application using a combination of ArcGIS Pro, a portal for ArcGIS Enterprise, and the Field Maps application for iOS. Here you can see one of our field operations specialists is collecting the inspection data and taking photographs. We then built a nice dashboard in ArcGIS Enterprise to track progress and examine the collected data. Notice the map and pop-ups in the lower right corner, and particularly the photo attachments. We needed to pull those photos out of ArcGIS Enterprise so that we could load them into our document management system. We use LaserFiche. We also needed an export of some of the inspection and photo attachment attributes so that the photos could be bulk loaded into LaserFiche with their required metadata. So I'm going to make kind of a bold statement here, and that's that working with attachments in ArcGIS can be challenging, but FME can make it easier. So I'm going to answer some questions now, such as how are attachments stored, how does FME read the attachments, and how do you save attachments to files? Now, in working with attachments, we encountered a number of challenges. We're using the ArcGIS Portal Feature Service Reader, but the same issues apply to the ArcGIS Online Feature Service Reader as well. And that's that the reader optionally exposes the attachments as a list attribute if there's at least one attachment on that feature. And each attachment in the list is made up of a number of attributes, including one that stores the actual document. Now, the document itself is stored as a base64 encoded binary large object or blob. For photos, if there's EXIF data attached, it's not stored in those attributes. Now, one important note, as of FME Desktop 2021.1, the version we're currently using, the feature reader transformers do not support accessing feature attachments from Portal or ArcGIS Online. You have to use an actual reader. So let's get into the solution now. So as you can see, this is not a large workspace. There's a reader, 8 transformers, and a writer. And this application, I'm using the Esri ArcGIS Portal Feature Service Reader. But all of the settings and behavior that you're going to see are identical for the Esri ArcGIS Online Feature Service Reader. For the purposes of this solution, I don't need the geometry. So the second transformer in on that workspace is a geometry remover. I'm getting rid of the geometry because it will improve the performance of the remaining part of the process. Now I'll walk through the rest of the workspace in more detail. We start with the reader. Now you must set the include attachments setting on the reader to yes in order to get the attachments and their data. If this is set to no, attachments are completely ignored by the reader. I then use the tester transformer to make sure there's at least one attachment on each feature. There's no point passing any features on that don't have attachments. In fact, it's likely an error will happen somewhere downstream if they aren't filtered out. The ArcGIS Online attachment attribute is the list attribute that holds all of the attachments for each feature. If there were no attachments on a particular feature, that list attribute would not exist. Thus, the testers checking for attribute is not missing, and the ones that features that have that attribute are allowed to pass. The attachment data is stored in a list attribute. Here I'm using a list exploder transformer to explode the list so that for each attachment, a new feature will emerge with the original features attributes and the attachments attributes combined. So basically, if the original feature had three attachments, three features will emerge from the list exploder. Next, I use the attribute manager transformer to remove most of the unneeded attributes from each feature. I also built the file name that I'll be using momentarily to save each attachment to a file. Here, any spaces are removed from the attachment's name attribute, and then it's appended to our common name identifier of the sewer structure, which came from the original feature itself. Also note the data attribute. That attribute came from the attachment and contains the attached document or photo. We'll be using that in the next few transformers. Remember I mentioned earlier that the attachment is a base 64 encoded binary large object. We need to decode it first using a binary decoder transformer so that we can write a usable file to disk. We also need to make sure that the character encoding remains set to binary. With the attribute file write transformer, you can write the contents of a single attribute directly to a file on disk. In this case, once again, I'm using that data attribute that now contains the binary object, free from the base 64 encoding. For the file name, I'm using a user parameter that stores a folder path, and then appending a backslash and the file name I created earlier with the attribute manager. Also, again note that the target file encoding is set to binary, so that the file is written properly. Now earlier I mentioned that the ArcGIS attachment didn't store any EXIF data for the photos. ArcGIS doesn't really know or need to know much about the attached documents. In order to get the EXIF data for the photos, each JPEG file needs to be read back in FME so that the EXIF attributes can be exposed. The feature reader reads back each of the files that were created by the attribute file writer in the previous step. I chose to use the single output port to keep things simple and to merge any exposed JPEG attributes with the attributes of the incoming feature. In this case, I'm exposing one particular EXIF attribute, JPEG EXIF date time. There are dozens of EXIF attributes that can be used. Lastly, I'm using another attribute manager to set up the data that I need to write out to Excel, which will be used when everything is imported into Laserfiche. I parse the date from the EXIF data because it's read in as a string and not a native FME date. I'm also building the virtual folder path that will be used inside of Laserfiche when the documents are bulk loaded. So in developing this workspace, we found a couple of things that I thought I'd pass on as helpful tips. Because the reader is loading not only the features, but also the attachment data along with them, the data will load much more slowly than if you were just reading the features alone, even in a high-speed environment. So the first tip is to limit the number of records to read until you're ready to actually do a full production run. And the way you do that is to set either max features to read or max features to read per feature type in the Navigator panel. And you'll find that under Reader Parameters and under Features to Read within that. Then remember to go back and clear that setting when you're ready to actually do the full production run so you can read all of your features. The second tip involves feature caching. Now, feature caching is a great feature when you're doing development, but it will add significant amount of time and resource consumption to the process when you're doing the full production run or reading a large number of features and their attachments. It may also crash your computer because it's basically writing out those features to a feature store file on your hard disk. And if you're reading a lot of features and a lot of attachments, that may end up filling your hard drive up completely and then causing a system crash. So make sure that you turn off feature caching when you do your production run. So the results of the workspace after we ran it in production, we got two output products. On the left, you can see there's a Windows folder that has about 33,000 JPEG photos in it. And on the right, we have the Excel spreadsheet that has about 33,000 rows of all of the associated metadata for those files. And together, those can then be used to bulk load all of this data into Laserfiche. The FME process took about 34 hours to complete for this batch of data. And once all those photos were loaded into Laserfiche, now they're accessible from links in our Vertigis GeoCortex web applications. As you can see on the left, after selecting one of our structures and getting the information on the pane on the left-hand side of the web map, clicking the link for asset management documents shows all of the available documents, and then clicking the link within that gives you the photos. So any one of our staff now has access to this information. So earlier I made a statement that working with attachments in ArcGIS can be challenging, but FME provides the tools that can make it easier. So now that all those photos are loaded into Laserfiche, as I said, they're accessible to all of our staff through multiple web applications. And because we built this workspace in FME, we can reuse it again as we have two more phases of work to complete. And when all is said and done, we'll probably have more than 80 to 90,000 photographs that will have to be loaded into our document management system. So to sum up, if you need to read and extract ArcGIS attachments for any reason, FME can help you to do it efficiently. Now, other attachment-related workflows can be developed using some or most of the workspace that presented, such as pulling down attachments from Portal or ArcGIS Online, and then putting them into a local or enterprise geodatabase. And before we go, I wanted to share a few resources that may be helpful if you're developing a similar workspace. The first two links there are to FME documentation for the two feature service readers, the format attributes for Portal and for ArcGIS Online. Then there's a link to an FME community article that deals with the whole Base64 encoding issue that I encountered. And lastly, the FME documentation for the JPEG reader. It documents all of the format attributes that you can work with, including all of the EXIF ones. Well, thank you again for your time this morning. If you have any questions or want to reach out for more information, there's my contact information. And I hope you enjoy the rest of the FME World Tour. Thank you again.